Hi, there are lots of new and exciting treatments for epilepsy this year other than medications alone. Let's go over them one by one. I'm your epilepsy specialized neurologist, Dr. Omar Danoun. Danoun is like noontime Danoun. That's how I say my name. About a third of patients do not respond to medications, and they are called drug-resistant epilepsy, and they need other types of treatment because medications will not cure their seizures. The first thing is the ketogenic diet. Ketogenic diet is a great addition to our treatment options for epilepsy, which includes modification of the diet and the food that we eat. So ketogenic diet is done under medical supervision with testing and evaluation under the doctor's and dietitian supervision. What we do is we increase the consumption of fat and decrease the consumption of carbohydrates, which will induce a state of ketosis, ketones in the body, and that will change the acidity in the blood and the brain, and this acidity will improve the seizures and stop them. And the diet is very successful, works in about, instead of working 1 to 2% with drug-resistant epilepsy, the diet works in about 40% of the cases and even more in some other cases. So the success rate is very good. And the diet does have some side effects, including like decreasing growth in children, fatigue, GI upset, stomach upset from all the fat, diarrhea, vomiting, and kidney stones. However, it can be a life-changing for some patients with epilepsy, and it usually is taken along with medications. And the diet is not for everybody, so you have to have a medical evaluation before, because some cases of genetic abnormalities affecting the mitochondria and the metabolism, they might not be compatible with the ketogenic diet. So ask your doctor if the diet is right for you. The second exciting advancement in epilepsy is surgical treatments. So in cases of maybe focal epilepsy, when the seizure starts in one area of the brain, there is a scar, spot of the brain, the cells do not form right, or mesial timber sclerosis, or any focal area that the seizure is starting from, we do testing and we prove that the seizures are all starting from that area. And if it is one spot and it is safe to take them out, we can excise that area, take it out surgically, which can significantly improve with a very good success rate. It can reach up to like 60 to 80% in some cases of like temporal lobe epilepsy when there is a clear scar in the brain, and that will be very good. So you will be taking anti-seizure medications to keep things calm. However, some patients, if seizures stop for years, you can be off your medications. And the excitement thing in surgical treatment is that now we have laser surgery. So this is the new thing. We can perform epilepsy surgery using laser. So instead of opening the skull, cutting through the brain, risk of complications, now we can do the same surgery with a laser probe that is a size of a pencil head. And this will be a small cut, 3 to 6 millimeters, through a hole in the skull, and that laser will go inside, will create heat, and then destroy those areas of the brain. Instead of cutting them out, it will coagulate those areas, and then we pull that laser, and the patients do very well, and the recovery time is super fast, and patients will be doing very well, and we can do the surgery. And it is important to know that there are limitations for the surgery through the laser. We have to have only one spot with a very clear and small area. So it works very well for the case of mesial temporal sclerosis. This is a common type of seizures when there is a scar in the temporal lobe, in the hippocampus specifically, and we just burn that hippocampus and stop the seizures. And we are testing it for other types of epilepsy actively, and I'm part of those clinical trials as well. And the laser is not widely available, and the doctors are not widely trained on it, but it will be rolling out more in the future. The third exciting treatment for epilepsy is neuromodulation, which is a new technology that we can use electricity and electrical stimulation to relieve seizures and help with epilepsy. And it can be done through multiple devices. The first device is called vagus nerve stimulation, VNS. This device is a small device that is put under the clavicle, and then the wire will go on the left side on the vagus nerve, so it's not even a brain surgery, and that will do electrical stimulation that goes into the brain and helps with the seizures. And then the second device is called deep brain stimulation. So deep brain stimulation, we implant the wires into the brain, inside the brain, small tiny wires that go all the way deep in the brain in an area called thalamus. So the thalamus is working like a hub station, a station that all the sensation and things go into the thalamus and move out. So it's kind of a strategic place to stimulate. It's kind of like, it's like the downtown metro station. All the trains come in and out. And this is where we stimulate strategically so that electricity will go throughout the brain. And this we use for areas of, like, there is multiple types, areas of seizures, or we cannot localize exactly where the seizures are coming from, or we cannot take it out surgically. And the third device, which is a very smart device, is called responsive neurostimulation, or RNS. So this device is like a tiny device that goes into the skull under the skin. You won't see it, and that we will put in wires or strips on the brain or inside the brain where the seizures are coming from, and then the device will start to record the brain activity all the time. And once it sees a seizure, it will give electrical stimulation to stop the seizure as it's going. It's kind of fighting fire with fire, if you would say. And with time, we will understand the brain seizures, and we train this device to recognize it better and be better and better at stimulating and stopping the seizures. So lots of new and exciting treatments. And if you want to know in details about all of those devices, how those devices are working, and if you want to see that actual device and know the risks and benefit and what percentage of activity will be successful, you can see this video where I explain all those devices in detail and in depth. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.